In this video, we are going to look at an example of defining the filter. I'm looking right now at the claims and weather data that tracks the customer information, the type of insurance policy that that customer has, and the claim type, claim reason, and the claim total claim amount. So this is the data module, and I'm looking at my data here. It's a lot of data, but suppose that I want to analyze only the sample of my data, and I want to look at the perhaps a sales channel, and I want the sales channel to be just the web, right? See, there are different values of the sales channel, and I want to look at the web only. And so what is a filter? Filter specifies the condition that must be true for the row to remain, right? If the row does not meet the filter condition, it will be filtered out. There are two types of filters. The type that we are looking at now is called embedded filter. Embedded filters apply immediately, as soon as they're defined. When I defined it, it will be immediately applied. So take a look at this. Right now, I have, if I see this, see the sell channel, right? I have agent, I have call center, I have web, etc. And I mentioned that I'm interested only in the web. So this is what you can do here. See this? Over here, you're gonna click on ellipsis and you're gonna select manage filters. Look, you're gonna select manage filters. Now, instead of selecting a column, what I'll do here is this. I do wire expression editor, right? Wire expression editor. Now, we're going to click on add filter. It's very important to use the descriptive filter name, right? So I'm gonna say filter sales channel, something like that, right? Now what you need to do is you need to specify the condition. So here is a list of fields. And in this case, I want to do sales channel. So I'm gonna drag and drop, right? In this case, I want to make it, the operator is going to be equal, or I can just type equal, right? I'm gonna type equal. And here I need to specify the value. Keep in mind that the values are case sensitive. So I remember that web was spelled, first letter was uppercase, right? So that's what you do. Now, what we need to do is we need to check the syntax. To do this, we click on validate. It means here the expression is valid. So we are good to go. But to make sure that our filter is saved, we have to click on OK. I clicked on OK, so let's go ahead, scroll down and see what's going on to our sales channel. Do you see this? Sales channel is right now web. We are looking at the web only, all right? And this is an embedded filter because it applied to my data immediately, see? It applied to my data immediately. Now, suppose that I change my mind, I want my sales channel to be either agent or web. This is what I can do. See this here, I'm on filters, right? And if I was not, look, I'll close this for a minute. Now, take a look, I want to modify my filters. So this is what you could do. You can do properties, then you can do filters. This is how to access this. And here, this is a filter that I created. It's listed here and it's clickable. If I click on it, I'm going to open the editor, right? Okay, so that's one way to access this. I click on editor. Over here, see, I see this definition. Right now, instead of limiting the data to web, I also want to use agent. This is what you want to do. There is an operator is called in over here. Let me show you. This is this operator in here. This is called in. Okay. And then in parentheses, you have to specify the delimited list of values. So here I'm going to put comma and then I'm going to put agent. Okay. Makes sense. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click OK. I'm going to click OK. And immediately when I scroll down, I'm going to see that my data is limited to what? Sales channel, agent, and web, right? So when I save this, and when I create my data explorations, and when I create my dashboards, and if I use this data module as a data source, the data that is visible to a user, right, would only be sales channel, agent, and web. There is no option to turn the filter on or off. We cannot, right? Unless we go here, open the data module and delete the filter, right? There is no way to, we don't have a choice, right? We cannot turn it on or off when we work on visualizations. It will be turned off, it will be turned on in the data module. All right. So let's close this out. Now remember this, you always want to have a descriptive name for the filter, because if you have more than one filter, having descriptive name would help figure out which filter you need to look at if you need to modify it. All right. So this was a short example of how to use the embedded filter. We're going to discuss the selectable filter in another video. Thank you for watching this video.